thank you, Jesus, for the victory that you have given to us. And truly, it's not by our might, not by our power, not by our own strength, but it's by the Spirit of God. Amen. This morning, let us just lift out our hands. We want to worship God. You know, the Bible says, let us present our body as a living sacrifice unto the Lord, to the one. That's right, just lift out your hand, church. know, just thank God in advance for the victory they will give us. You know, the Bible says the Egyptians, the enemies that you see today, you will see them no more, forever. The enemies that you see today, you will never see them anymore, ever again. The sickness, the barrenness, the depression, the panic, anxiety, all the attack that you see today, you will see them no more, no more, no more. Come on, lift up your hands. Oh, shout your victory song.
Lift it up, lift it up. open our mouth to speak in tongues right now. So we're going to bless the Lord. Just tell him how much you love him. Just focus in on the Lord this morning. Jesus is closer to you than your very breath. Just love him, just receive his love. There's an open heaven over us this morning. Lord, we bless you, we worship you.
Today, even as we are in this place, Jesus loves us so much. Even as we listen to the song, there is this that Jesus won the victory for us. Jesus loves us. His death and resurrection, his victory is all for us. Jesus wants us to live a victorious life. Today, even as we are here, let's receive the love of God. I'm reminded of Judges in chapter 6. It talks about this man who was called Gideon. Gideon was feeling all hopeless in verse 11. He felt so hopeless that the Midianites were attacking them. He felt so hopeless and he was just threshing wheat in a wine press. He was so hopeless that he just hid himself in a wine press. But then in verse 12, it says the angel of the Lord came. The angel of the Lord came, and what did the angel of the Lord say to him? The Lord is with you, mighty warrior. The Lord is with you, mighty warrior Gideon. And for that moment, he has doubt in his heart. He said, but God, I went through so much. Why didn't you give us the victory? And the Lord kept reassuring him that I am with you. And we know the end of the story. It says that with just 300, you know, in Gideon's army, they defeated 1,335 Midianites. Friends, tonight, this afternoon, this morning, as we are standing here, maybe we felt that we are just in a hopeless situation. But let's remember what God has done on the cross for us. Jesus has won the victory for us. Jesus reminded us, he didn't do it for just nobody, but he did it for every single one of us in this place. Today, God loves us so much. And I sense a breakthrough, a spirit of breakthrough in this place. Maybe some of us, we are in this hopelessness, but God says, I am your hope. Maybe some of us here, we have so much anxiety in our heart, but God said, my perfect love will cast out every single fear. Maybe some of us here, no, I just hear the Lord saying that you are trying out for a baby. You are trying out for so long and just like Gideon, you felt so defeated. But today, I speak for breakthrough into your life. I say, God will give us the baby that we want. God will restore the marriage. God will restore us. So today, friends, let's lift our hands. Let's praise God for all the victory that is given to us.
I love you.
pastor for a moment. This morning, no matter what your giant is, you heard the prophetic word, God is for us. Gideon's 300 men were able to defeat 135,000 Midianites. No matter how great the odds is, your giant may be as big as Goliath. But the important thing is you have a champion, and his name is Jesus. And he lives inside you, and he's for you, and he's with you. He's beside you, he's in front of you, he's behind you, above you, underneath you. He's with you from the morning to the evening, from your coming to your going. The Lord, your champion, is with you. So this is what we're gonna do. No matter what your sickness is, no matter what financial difficulty you're going through, maybe you're facing a challenging time in your business, maybe you're going through a heartbreak, maybe there's a challenging situation at home, maybe you're going through something in your marriage or with your kids, no matter what your situation is, or maybe it's even ministry in church, in a cell group, this morning, speak to the mountain. Speak to that wall. The wall of Jericho will come tumbling down. We're going to sing the bridge one more time. What does it say on the bridge? When I lift my voice and shout, every wall comes crashing down. I have the authority Jesus has given to me. If you believe that, give the Lord a big clap. Hallelujah. Are you ready? I want you to declare it. I want you to declare. Speak to your mountain. Speak to your wall. Speak to your Goliath. Hallelujah. Give praise. Amen.